Welcome to my channel. This is my presentation number 10 for how to draw a house in one point perspective. And again, I will be using Corona Sketchpad and a pencil number 2. And of course, a triangle with grid lines. In drawing a perspective, always put your horizon line and of course your vanishing point as well, because this will serve as your primary guide. And in here, I'm drawing first the massing of my building and specifically the highlight or accent of my design. And for this presentation, I want to minimize the use of glass with a touch of modern design. And as you can see, it's more on linear and geometric shape, which is one characteristic of modern architecture. And for the balcony, I wanted to make it like it's hanging, so I protruded in a practical distance from the main building. And after you have completed outlining your massing, you can now put also your details such as the windows, doors, railings, accent walls, and etc. And of course, always incorporate your entourage, the trees, plants, or plant box and vehicles. I also wanted to put vertical louvers in the balcony, so I put some in the left portion. And I also wanted to show transitions of materials in my design. For the right portion, a groove, in the middle, a concrete or cement texture, and for the left portion will be brick tiles. And you can see that when we will be rendering in this drawing. And after you have completed sketching your design or drawing, you can now finalize it with an ink. And here, I will be using a Unipin fine line 0.3. And if you can observe on how I ink my drawing, I start to do it with the massing. Then go into the details afterwards. But if you are comfortable in doing portion by portion, you can do so. And by the way, for those who subscribe this channel, thank you for supporting. And if you are not yet subscribed, please do support this channel. And for other sketches or perspective drawings, feel free to visit my Instagram account and Facebook page. And for the previous tutorials, you can see the links in my description box below. And if you want to emphasize your edges or corners of your building, you can use thicker or broader ink. But if you don't have, you can just double line it with an ink that you are using. For the eaves and ceiling, I wanted to be paneled, so I put termination lines. And after you have completed or finalized inking, you can now choose what rendering material you want to use. And for this, I will be applying mixed medium. And for For shadows, I used colored markers with the brand name of Corecolor. I used the warm gray 4, and the corners that have the least light source, I used warm gray 7, which is darker. And by the way, in determining your shadows, you need to locate first your light source or sun, and this will identify the distance of your shadows into the surface. Completed putting shadows, you can now apply the base color of the surfaces of your design or building. And I used watercolor for rendering, and the brand name is Brown. And for me, in watercolor, I always apply my background then go into the foreground. And remember, in painting the sky, always start from light to dark so that you can control the lightness and hardness of the tone. For the entourage, I use yellow green for my base color. Then we'll repeat it with green after it dries. For the eaves and ceiling, I applied raw sienna to give contrast to the wall, which has darker color, like for example, the groove that has wood texture. I also painted the driveway with darker brown, made the balcony more emphasized. Then for the glass, I applied light blue, then we'll repeat it with darker blue to show depth and shade. And remember to put some gaps for reflections. Same with the vehicles, when painting it, put some gaps to show reflections, then paint a harder tone in the edges. Then, you can now repeat applying the texture or surface with the desired tone of paint. For the brick wall, I just used a flat brush and brush it only with the tip of it. Thank you. And now for the grooves with wood texture, I applied with harder tone of brown to make it more appealing and to show the imperfections of the texture of wood. Finalize your entourage. Put some shades, shadows, and brighter color of green. And for the glass or windows, you can also use white ink or correction fluid to show highlights and reflections. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Please do support this channel by simply clicking like, subscribe, and click the bell button to be updated for upcoming videos. And for the previous video tutorials, the links are in the description box below. And for more perspective drawings or sketches, feel free to visit my Instagram account and Facebook page. The links are also in the description box below.